Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2348. Guess your age from your given name. And books, roller coasters, superheroes, and authors. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. It was a week ago when I tried to use Wolfram Alpha data types to guess people's age based on their favorite music acts. Well, this week, I'm going to try something completely different, still using Wolfram Alpha data types. And instead of the Excel MVPs, I went out to the people who have left comments on this YouTube channel, 5,825. I chose the top commenters, the people who have been commenting for a long time or just had a lot of comments, all of these folks right here. And I want to thank you for your continued support of the channel. And I tried to guess your given name. Maybe I got it. Maybe I didn't. Hard to say. Using these given names, can I figure out your age? Let's get started.
Hey, speaking of YouTube comments, it was Robert Flynn who said, hey, can you show us what the what they have on amusement parks? So certainly number of rides and number of roller coasters is there. We'll take a look at the card here. Where it is, city, country, latitude, longitude, some dates, the date that it opened, whether or not it's still open or not, status open, year-round, website, dimensions, number of rides, image location, local map, right? So kind of cool. If you're a roller coaster fan, you can figure out which parks have the best or the most roller coasters. Well, we've seen in the past how the Wolfram Alpha data types have real people, like musicians, but they also have a whole list of fictional characters here. So your favorite comic book characters or movie characters in a lot of cases are here with some interesting information. But do they have us? That's the big question. Well, at least they have our given names. So I put everyone's given names in here, and I went to data types, and chose automatic. I actually put the name and then given name, space, given name, lowercase. And a lot of them, it was strange. It just popped right up. But then others, like Chris, it said, do you mean Chris a male or Chris a female? So there were actually a lot here that I had to choose. Now let's see what kind of information they offer for us. We have alternate versions. So is this name like Andreas is Andre or Andy, Dennis, Dean, Den, Denny, Denny, Dino. Dino, what a great name. I had a cousin named Dino. Hey, Dino, how's it going? And then the origin of the word. So, you know, short form, but sometimes it's, the old Celtic element meaning hill or high or noble. But the things that are pretty interesting here are the ones where they will guess your age. And how can they guess your age? I've actually seen this trick before. So here I have Mike, short form of Michael, no alternate versions, which is weird. It should be Michael. The current naming frequency, and then how many people are alive today with that name, 166,710, and the most common age. And the way they get that is they take the U.S. births. So here's this is equal A3.history for U.S. births, and figure out lifespans, right? So these people who were born back here in 1880, probably not with us anymore. So then based on that, how old are all the current living Michaels? And you can see somewhere here about 49 or 50 is where it peaks. And so their guess, most common age, is 50. Now, I remember at the amusement parks, you used to be able to go through and give the guy $2 and he would guess your name, guess your weight, or guess your month you were born. I'm sure he wasn't doing anything as scientific as this. But let's see what happens here. So we'll get rid of these two columns, right click and delete, and then say that we want to see most common age, all right? And really, it would be great if I could throw out anything under than 10. Most common age greater than 10 would be a very, very cool way to go. There's a lot of people here that the name has become much more common. Like, for example, Oz. You know, a lot more people are naming their kids Oz ever since the Excel on Fire channel became a thing on YouTube. And then people are like, oh, that guy is super cool. We're going to name our kid Oz, right? Well, obviously, two-year-olds aren't leaving comments on the channel, right? So that one's not really real. But a few of these, like here, let's look up Bill. It says 51. Close. They got the right decade. And if we come back here, and type in an 11, this will switch to Bill. The notable person with his name is Bill Gates. How cool is that? And there were kind of a couple of peaks here. Back in the 30s, around 35, Bill was very popular. And then right around 1960, and I was born in the 60s there. So it's actually pretty cool what they came up with here for all of us and what our age is. I'll kind of scroll through there. Obviously, if it says 4 or 5, it's not close. If you don't mind, down in the YouTube comments, if you're in this list, you might say, hey, yeah, that's close for me, or not at all. Ham, 81. I'm not even sure that was Ham's real name. And then, let's see, current naming frequency, number of people alive. Expected total number alive today. We'll sort that high to low. All right, James, 3.7 million James, 3.5 million Johns, 3 million Davids, 1.9 million Richards, and so on down here at the other end of the spectrum. And I wonder if this is in the United States, because a lot of people who are possibly from India or elsewhere around the world are very, very low, and there have to be a lot of people with those names in your country. So I'm guessing that Wolfram Alpha is basing this on U.S. Social Security numbers or something like that. Has to be something that they're pulling out here. So this is pretty cool. Also, the other thing I did, you can see here that you put in a name and it brings up all the notable people with this name. And then from this cell right here, from F7, I asked for the image. All right, so it's kind of cool to go through and see for each of these people, for your name, who's the most famous person that has that particular name. So for me, it's Bill Gates. You know, a variety of people. There's Harry Potter, Daniel Radcliffe, some singers, politicians, heads of state, Jack Black. How do they decide that person's most notable? Not sure. All right, but at least you know, when you say, you know, my name's Michelle, people say, oh, are you Michelle Rodriguez? And you're like, no, I'm the other Michelle. The second most famous Michelle. All right, so there you go, the new Wolfram Alpha data types. You know, the one that caught my eye right away was notable texts, like notable books. I mean, I write books, right? And look at all these books they have. They tell you who the author was, what the author's date of birth was, and that had to be a challenge because 1819, Excel doesn't recognize that date, so that one comes in as text. John Steinbeck, though, comes in as a real date. Or Confucius at BC 551, negative 0551. What a challenge to have to put old dates in there. And we take Mark Twain, and we can see other books written by Mark Twain. And this is great that Wolfram Alpha thinks that these are notable texts. But let's face it, if you're watching this podcast, these aren't your notable texts. If you're like me, these are the notable texts. These are the texts that I learned Excel from, right? And the question is, does Wolfram Alpha know these texts? So, data types, automatic. Zip, none of them. Oh, how disappointing is this? These are the books that we use to learn Excel. Let's take the authors that wrote those books and see if Wolfram Alpha knows any of us. Certainly John Walkenback would be in there. No deal on Walkenback. Oh, hey, Mike Alexander from DataPig Technologies. He's the only one. Congratulations, Mike. You are the baller of all of these Excel authors. Although it's because of your former career as a football player who played for the Los Angeles Raiders and the Buffalo Bills, obviously before he started becoming the Excel guy.
All right, on my quest for a better merch experience, better high-quality shirts, I need 100,000 subscribers. Please, down below, click subscribe. 83% of you not subscribed right now. I won't hassle you. I won't spam you. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, click that I in the top right-hand corner. Look, I really want to thank everyone that's watching. I appreciate it. I appreciate your support of the channel over the years. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Tips and tricks, get your spreadsheet fixed at MrExcel.com.